लाइट्स नहीं चमक रही, ये वाली बंद तो नहीं कर रहा?
नहीं। गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अमित गोयल। आई वेलकम यू टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ बिकमिंग अ नॉलेज वर्कर। हियर इन बिकमिंग अ नॉलेज वर्कर वी डिस्कस विद वेरी सक्सेसफुल प्रोफेशनल्स हाउ दे मैनेज देयर करियर। एंड टुडे आई हैव विद मी मिस्टर आर के दुबे।
हेलो सर।
थैंक यू। हेलो
मिस्टर दुबे इज लाइक अ फादर फिगर टू मी। ही इज अ मेंटर, आई रिस्पेक्ट हिम अ लॉट, यू नो, एंड ही हैज अ वेरी इलस्ट्रियस करियर। Starting on with the Punjab National Bank as a management trainee, he grew up to become the executive director of Central Bank of India and later the chairman of Canara Bank. When he became the chairman, he told his team that I'm going to make this elephant dance. And yes, he did make the elephant dance. He turned around the P&L of this loss-making bank. So today, Mr. Dubey, we would like to learn from you not how you made the elephant dance, but how you made Rajiv Kumar Dubey into what he became. So we would like to learn from you about the first 25 years of your journey.
Well, Amit, it's a nostalgic feeling it brings you when somebody asks this question. Well, I think I have been a self-made person and I am very happy about it. When you acquire something which you plan for, which you dreamed at, and when you work for it, if you get it, you really feel satisfied. I am definitely a very contented person. My father instilled me a belief in me that you should have firm belief in your capacity. I realized having belief in yourself doesn't work alone. You should have belief in people, because we work with people. You work either under people or people work under you. You are amidst people. So you have to learn to move with the people, make teams, make them perform, you automatically will. So I had a lot of impact in my life during my whole life. I found life is an evolving. Initially you have, you know, like I was a very shy boy, I remember. Okay. But as you grow along, someday you realize that you need to come out of your shell. Mm-hmm. So if you have a determination, if you have a willpower, if you want to do something in your life, if you want to achieve something, because, you know, ambition level was very high for me. And I used to dream a lot. Okay. I remember in Times of India, one day I read an article. Those days were the days of Dhirubhai Ambani. Dream big, desire big, it big happens. This simple line I am telling you, the catch tagline. Dream big, desire big, big happen. The crux of that article was, one, you need to dream. When you dream, don't dream small. Dream as much as you can. Maybe you get it fulfilled, maybe you don't. Then try to get it. For trying to get it, you need to work very sincerely, very hard, with a lot of devotion, dedication. Even if you are less intelligent, by hard work you can compensate those lack of quality. I felt hard work, sincerity is more important than being born intelligent. I think I was a reasonably good person in academics, not very intelligent, but I acquired it by and by. Because I wanted to learn. So I was a continuous learner. Learning became a passion for me.
Right.
If you feel, even now, I feel I am learning. So if you become a learner for life, one thing more I learned while I was preparing for some exam, you need to be quick learner also. Quick learner. You know, you can't say that I have been here around for so much. No, you have to be quicker. You have to pick up things fast, identify, understand, and then acquire it. Like, you know, one tagline again haunted me in my life. Alexander had told, I came, I saw, I conquered. It is simple, but it is very difficult. It is not that anywhere in life you can do, I came, I saw, I conquered. You know, that meant to me, yes, I came, I saw the things around, I heard around, and I conquered. That means you have to be quick learner. See, when I became regional manager, now I take you back. My branch managers used to tell, sir, I have just come and joined. I said, 1 year is over. You said you have just come. Then I found, if in 3 months, 3 months is an optimum period. I am not saying the minimum.
Right.
If in 3 months, you cannot understand the whole things, identify the problem, and start working on solving them, perhaps you will always be saying, I have just come. So if you are a quick learner, because you are passionately involved, your involvement is to be 100%. You know, I believed always, Amit, less than 100% doesn't work. Half-hearted efforts don't work. You have to devote fully. If you submerge your identity in that work, so you have to enjoy the work. One is, work is itself enjoyable, whatever be the work. So sometimes I look back and I found banking is a very boring job. But if you start enjoying it, you find a lot of excitement in that. You get a lot of new things in that. You start initiating new things. You start innovating various ways of doing things. So if your eyes and ears are open, because we were joined the banking 1977, when there was a manual banking, ledger and everything. Now turning to online banking, working on email all the time, running on by moving and then you have to be online CBS. I was IT AGM in PNB. I'm telling you, it's a transformation. I told my boss, why are you putting me in IT? I'm not a tech-savvy guy. But then, I learned there again. That came so handy. So every opportunity that you get in life, every opportunity, never fritter it away.
Right.
That opportunity you convert to your strong area.
Right.
How you can learn in that opportunity. So, Amit, the hard work, passionately, with devotion. My father used to say, look at bull's eye.
Okay.
What Arjun was told by Lord Krishna, I need to aim and hit at bull's eye. Always try that. So that was my thing. So you have to have a goal.
Right.
Now coming to goal, I said you that you need to be ambitious. I was very ambitious. Those ambition level and goals my father set initially, and then they became my own. So if you have a goal that is equivalent to your dream, what I was telling you, and another line again, haunts me. There was a poem I read, Scholar Gypsy by Matthew Arnold. It's a beautiful poem. One line I have quoted. That is, Scholar Gypsy, he was a wanderer. He had one aim, one business and one desire. Only one. It is difficult, a wanderer having that. So that means focused approach. If you have an aim in your life, you want to shoot it, then you put all your energies with full enthusiasm and vigor, and you put life and soul behind it. How it cannot be achieved, I always felt. And if still you cannot get it, don't lose heart. Be optimist. Believe in yourself. Believe in your people. Believe in God. One thing I learned over a time, whatever you do, if it is not to happen, it doesn't happen. And if it is to happen, then it happens. What I mean to say, I don't say that people need to turn toward that. But yes, somewhere in subconscious mind, this feeling I develop that yes, there is some supernatural agency which controls our destiny, what we call destiny, what we call luck. You need to have that also. But you have not to look at it. You have to believe in your energy, your hard work. Many things can be transformed by that. Otherwise, the latent capacity will be known even to you, that you can do that. Like Hanumanji, he was to be always reminded. So we need to remind ourselves that we can. And if you don't get it, suppose by so much of work and hard work, don't get dejected. Again, I say positivity and optimism. Hardcore optimist. I used to smell a person who is near me. If he is a negative type of man and positive talking, I would keep myself away. Either I will turn him positive, optimist, or else I'll not part. I'll part with that friend because he may infect me. Wrong things have faster infection.
Correct.
So keep away from negativity.
Energy vampires.
Yeah. So this is what was the aim in life, to do something, to contribute, to work hard with passion, dedication, devotion. And you know, I always felt for people, initially, I was very soft on people. I found life is not that easy. People are not that easy. People come from different walks of life, different background. They are good, they are bad, they are schemer, they are, you know, they are of different type. So you need to be careful. We found you can even transform people. Amit, you know, you can even transform people. I found the basic thing somebody taught me, that it is 1/3 people who do 100% jobs.
Right.
You will watch, Amit, I am telling you, even you are a young like my son. They say, again I say, basic management concept. 1/3 people doing 100% job. Nowhere more than that happens.
Right.
That means, whatever good or bad system, because those 1/3 are performers by birth.
Right.
They will perform even if you promote them or not, even if you harm them, you don't give them, you know, you don't give them increment, you make their condition, working condition bad, still they will perform.
Right.
It is in their genes that they would perform. Not doing, you are not doing anything for them, they perform.
And these 1/3 emerge to be on top.
Now, right, you know, now I'm just, you know, you are hearing for the first time, you analyze now. Second 1/3 are followers. I tell them follower. They are fence sitters.
Right.
They would watch the environment, mahal. They would see how is the boss, whether there is a work going on, work gets recognition, they will shift.
Right.
1/3 would be passengers who would never bother about work. As long as they were not getting work, they were unhappy. The moment they get work, contentment comes, they would always grumble, they would always blame this or that for their failure.
Right.
So, challenges for an executive or for you or me as a manager or as a leader is to identify those fence sitters,
right,
transform those easy persons from follower to the performer category. If you are able to convert 50% people to performer, you have won the day. The last 1/3 transformation is difficult, but I kept on trying always. I found even hardcore people could be transformed. I experimented on people. It worked. For that, you know, you need to be compassionate. You need to have good heart. You need to sometimes be, one of my teacher used to call me tough love. I believe in tough love. Love, but tough love. Means I am a very hard task master. I will not compromise on task. But I would love people. I would look to people, his capacity. If his capacity is less, we can create capacity in him. We can empower him further. We can educate him further. We can groom him further. So it is our duty to transform people, to realize their strength, to know by your inspiring work, by your word, by your motivation, so that they also do their best. If we are able to get best out of the people working with us, and we are able to transform them from last 1/3 category to first category, second 1/3 category to first category, I tell you, this is what I kept on doing all through my life. Some of them who transformed, they became the thickest friends of my life. You know, some of my bosses used to give me a union leader. Dubey, he doesn't work. He's a rogue. He's a union guy. You keep him. I don't know, after 2-3 months,
what to do.
He would be my best friend.
Okay.
He would touch my feet, come sir, sir, sir. And now they are all AGM and DGM. You know, because I just converted them, the importance of work,
right,
the recognition. You need to recognize people.
Right.
Yes, being in public sector, Amit, I found that I don't have too many things to give to the good workers. I found some discriminatory law. Those doing very well, I would acknowledge them a lot. Those not doing well, I would definitely distinguish so that they get tempted to do better. But sometimes they were not. They became either jealous or unhappy with me. I found all these things. So I used to experiment with them, how to convert them.
Right.
You know, various types of incentives, monetary, non-monetary, by training abroad, various types of things you have to see, because human beings are sensitive, they feel bad, you know, small things affect their psyche, it's a tough, you know, that is why when I was doing MBA, one of my teachers, his name was S.P. Khanna,
okay,
he used to write S.P. Rosemind. We asked him, sir, what is the meaning of Rosemind? Bole, one whose mind is like rose. You know, he was 85 years old. He used to be very punctual and regular in the classes. Would always be taking the maximum interest in the classes. That is the best class I had in my MBA. Mm-hmm. And he was teaching us. He was HR manager of BHEL Bhopal. He was expert on counseling psychology. Means, you counsel people when they are in distress,
right,
when they are unhappy, when they are not able to contribute. Rather than condemning them, counsel them.
Right.
So, taking care of the people was really, I found, if you counsel people well, if you take care of the meeting in life. Another thing I found with people, that as a senior or then as an elder, we need to learn to forget and forget. This is the toughest quality I found, a challenge. Forget and forget. What happens? We become vindictive. We you know, human tendency is to be revengeful. He has done harm to me. Now, you know, I became loving even to those who were my critic. I knew them, they were always trying to harm me, they were critic, but still love them. It is difficult, I am telling you. I often used to say, easy things anyone can do. Difficult things only courageous people or the good leaders can do.
Right.
So, we need to, this I learned from the Jain Dharma.
Okay.
I tell you, certain things had a very deep impression in my life. When I was management team and I joined as a scale 1 officer in Satna, a small district. My manager was, I remember, you know, he might be there, still there,
he's watching.
Mr. K.C. Jain. He was the branch manager, quite aged person. I was hardly 22, 23. He was, must be 45, 50. He used to take me and I used to fight with him, being younger, my difference of opinion, but I was very hardworking. I became an asset to him. He rather became redundant in the branch. I used to feel why he should be redundant. I used to give him regard. But every one day, he will come to me begging with folded hands, Dubeji, forgive me. Today is our forgiveness day. You know what they say? Forgiveness is divine. It is really divine. So I used to think about it. It is really difficult task. Like one thing I could never learn, you know, listening in the job. Listening in the job is poor for all leaders. I also tried entire my life. I would say I got only 4 or 5 out of 10. But this empathy feeling or this feeling of forgiveness, I could cross even 6 or 7. I was never vindictive towards anyone. I would never blame for my predecessor, never will do a blame game. I would only be fine. Let the bygones be bygones. Let us move on. Let us move on. So with that approach, with that positive mindset, with that optimistic mindset, and you know, a tenacity, and an approach where never give up. Nothing is impossible in the world. I was clear always, nothing is impossible. Perhaps it is more difficult,
right.
So you need to make more efforts. You need to try more. You need to try more. So that was the thing. With this type of approach, I think you can succeed, my dear friends, anywhere in life, any subject in life. One more thing I would say. Help others. Always be helping to others. In whatever way possible, if you have a tendency to helping people, helping others in distress, in need, that will give you a satisfaction. You know, what they call job satisfaction.
Right.
After working hard, after helping people, the satisfaction that I got was bigger than any money that I could. That is one thing I always felt, that help people and attain excellence means do your best. Whatever you do. Some people ask me, sir, I want to do MA, LLB. I say you do. You do what you like,
right.
But you do your best.
Right.
you know, whatever course you choose, whatever job you choose, whatever assignment you get, don't think that it is a bad or it is, you know, inferior. Every job is good. If somebody has to do that job.
Right.
Do your best in that job. Nobody can match that best. This is the spirit which drove me on. And that is why I felt, in most of the assignments that I've heard, I never failed because I never found that I could fail. I always found that I need to do a little different here. You need to do little more here.
Right.
If you do little more, little different, you will be able to. For everything, I think, you know, there is a way out.
Right.
So if that approach we have, we can really achieve wonder. We can achieve anything that we desire. We can do anything for the society or to further your career. It is not related to either banking or business. I am very, very confident if I start a business, you know, the same principles, same fundamentals, they go into business, trade, industry, politics, anywhere. So you have to adapt. So adaptability is also very important. And that is why, you know, when we were transferred during our entire life, we never asked for change. Wherever we went, we took our family. Children going from 9 to 10, 10 to 11, 11 to 12, wherever. So they learn adaptability. They learn how to live good with different type of people, with from different languages, from different culture, and then assimilate with them and enjoy.
So guys, that's an MBA leadership program and career coaching all rolled into one 15-minute talk. You don't need to go to any university in the world. Just listen to this 15-minute discussion and you'll get all the management and leadership skills that you need. Now, my next question to Dubey sir is that a lot of people, you know, do an MBA right after their graduation, whereas you worked in the bank for about 10 years before doing an MBA. So what is your opinion? Is it right to first work in the industry and then do an MBA, or should people just complete their management education and then do work?
I have a very flexible mind on this point, Amit. Logically, one should not do MBA immediately after graduation because you are raw. You would only learn bookish things and then only you have to apply them. Better do some base qualification, maybe graduation, maybe post-graduation, whatever suits to anyone. And then better do a job.
Right.
On the job training is the real training in the world, because you know the job market has nothing to do with academic life.
Correct.
What we learn in BSc, BA, BCom, very little is used in the job.
Correct.
Situation. Job situation is the real challenge. So after working for even 2 years is okay.
Right.
Four, the more it is better. 4 years, 5 years. Then if you upgrade your skill by doing MBA from good institute. Of course, MBA should be done from a good institute.
Correct.
Although on that also I have a catch. I did from a very small, ordinary institute. But I wanted to learn. There was a thing in my mind. And I did, you know, not as a full-time MBA, part-time MBA.
Right.
But I wanted to learn. So I learned. If you don't want to learn, even in the good institute, you may not learn.
So when you were doing your MBA, that 10-year experience would have come in a lot of...
yes, rather 12 years. I joined in 77, I did from 89, 90 to 94.
Right.
After 13 years, I did MBA.
Right.
By that time, I had become a manager already. So you became a seasoned manager by the time you... You can correlate situations.
Correct, correct.
And then can understand the implications of the things what you...
Right.
That is how I found I won't specialize even if a banker in finance. That was easier for me.
Mm.
I specialize in HR. And within HR I worked in counseling psychology. That means people. I found in my life managing people the toughest job than managing any work.
Is this the experience which led you to become the chairman? Because not everybody from management training
could be Amit that. Could be that. But yes, loving people, getting best out of people, people management I found. Yes, this could be when I look back as one of the strong things that I had, which many others may or may not have.
Right. So, sir, today we are living in a connection economy.
Right.
You know, where networking is a very important skill. So, you know, I learned a couple of years later that I need to start building networks, know people, stay in touch with them. And I'm sure somewhere in your career, it has helped you also grow to the top. What advice would you give to other young professionals?
See, if one is a good PR man, PR means if you talk sweetly, Right. What I told you, the people quality.
Right.
If you love people, you will talk sweetly. Right. You will talk nicely. If you can talk well, if you can work well, you will win friends and people in any public forum. You can do good marketing. Why I did choose marketing? Because if you can talk well, if you can talk sweetly, you can do marketing.
Right.
Marketing is what basically PR, promoting a product,
right,
selling a product.
Right.
If you are good in these things, so for that also I would say HR skill is more essential.
Right.
So therefore, if you are good in those things, you definitely would excel anywhere you go. Dealing with people is very essential. Networking with the people, getting their best. Otherwise, you will be in the shell. One has to go out of the shell. You have to do your, you know, out, this is what we call outer box thinking.
Right.
Outer box thinking only comes when you work out of the box. So for that, you need to move around. You need to talk to people. You need to know and learn from the people.
Right.
And it is a two-way process. They may say or they may not,
correct,
but it is for them also.
Yes.
So that's a brilliant answer, you know. Now, earlier in your career, did you have any career dilemma? Most of the kids often are confused whether to do this or not. Did you also have any career confusion?
Yes, very much.
So,
you know, I wanted initially to be an IAS officer because I only knew one career in my life which my father told IAS. But whatever I did, it was nowhere near that. Incidentally, I did graduation BSc from a small college government in Hindi medium.
Okay.
Those days in early 70s, English medium was compulsory.
Okay.
So now it is not.
For civil services.
Yeah. So I found I am what I look for, what I aspire and what I'm doing, they don't match.
Right.
So I shifted gear. Rather than regretting, I shifted gear. Mm-hmm. I learned English. I did MA in English Literature. I did law in English, although the whole college did in Hindi medium. So I moved. I read Times of India for 4 or 5 hours daily with, you know, Webster Dictionary, Oxford Dictionary. So, you know, I told you, steadfast focus. Now I have to learn the language. What is there? You know, people are, they know 10 languages.
Right.
They also get. English is after all a language now.
Right.
You need to know. Fine. I didn't have the atmosphere and the environment which we created. You know, it was all created and I learned. And after that, then I wanted to be, you know, and then, you know, I got admission in. I wanted to go to Allahabad University because that was those days very famous for IAS coaching and all. Delhi is now famous. I went there and I didn't get admission in MSc Physics. Although I had 76% marks in BSc. I got in Applied Physics and Amit, that was a B.Tech course.
Okay.
When I joined, I realized that it is a B.Tech course, B.Tech in Electronics and it was a shock to me of my life. 4 months I somehow pulled on because I was only son of my father and I didn't have dared to tell him that I don't want to do this after having joined. One day I left it.
Okay.
Went home receiving a telegram from the institute, Rajiv Kishore absconded.
Oh my God.
I told my father. My father told, okay, you send. My father didn't force me. He didn't crush. He told, okay, you do what you like. Again, he told me the same thing. Do your best. Don't do something for hearsay or just for the sake of doing or for the heck of doing. Okay, yes, I know what I am doing. I left engineering college, Allahabad University. I focused on English. I focused on my knowledge. I started writing competitive exam. One after other, I started qualifying them. I landed up in bank as a management trainee PO. Somehow, after some time, initially I didn't like banking at all. I wrote a big letter, I remember, Indian letter from Hyderabad to my father. It's a useless job, I don't like it. Accountancy, I don't like, I want to leave it. But he counseled me. He came to Indore to counsel me in 1977, December, January, and told, no, you continue, it's a good job and keep trying for other things also. Initially I had, but when I settled in banking, I found that this is the good where I can make my career. Then I focused, I did all related exams of banking, CIB part 1, part 2. Then I did MBA to acquire more skills.
Right.
So everything that was required to do, after having topped in MBA in HR, I was picked up by DGM HR in head office in PNB Delhi. Mr. Vasan was the, you know, DGM, Srinivasan. He was earlier from BHEL or some private sector. He picked me when I taught. And he sent me abroad to a Manchester college, Manchester Business School, for a 3 months course. Tremendous learning I got, because that were those were my formative years.
Right.
I was very young at that time, that was 92. And I was 15 years old in the bank, only a senior manager, skill 3. Having done my graduation, post-graduation, law, then my MBA, I got that exposure of London for 3 months. From Manchester University. It really opened my eye. Then he sent me for another training in Christ College, Cambridge.
Okay.
So what I mean to say,
that's where you learn financial.
I learned a lot. So every opportunity that I got, I grabbed it as a godsend opportunity, and I tried to learn as much as it was possible for me. That was the key to success anywhere and everywhere.
So sir, this is the same dilemma that every student I work with faces after he joins his first job. You know, nobody, I've worked with thousands of students, nobody likes their first job, and most of the times, in absence of counseling from father like yours, you know, they leave that first job. What advice would you give to students?
Amit, you and me need to be good counselors. We elders, we seniors, we should guide people, we should counsel people with love and affection. In the, you know, to the extent they get influenced.
Right.
They try to understand, they believe in our capacity, they believe in us, and we are able to guide. I am telling you, if with no benefit, personal benefit, mm-hmm. if you selflessly do counseling and coaching and guiding, people would believe you. And if few success stories, if you generate, I am telling you, it is required. Because youngsters, looking to the so many attractions around, they get sometimes, you know, distracted.
Right.
They get confused as to what to do.
Correct.
I think they need, most of them, they need loving counseling. If you go to abroad, I went abroad, you will find every school, college has a counselor.
Right.
In India, you will hardly find anywhere role of a counselor. Those, if you are alone there, you know, you are remembering your family, you are not liking the subject, you are liking, counselor will, you know, take out all your, that is why in India people commit suicide and all those. We need counseling with
right.
love and compassion. Maybe if really he needs a change, let him change.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, he should appreciate and like what he is doing. You know, this is also very important. Somebody told me one day, I won't tell you the incident. There is a small prayer. Oh Lord, give me courage and strength to do what I can do. You know, I am telling you the limitations of the person. Whatever I can do, I must do.
Right.
Right? Oh Lord, give me courage and strength to accept what I cannot do. Problem is comes here. We don't accept everything you cannot do. We should accept sometimes.
Right.
And third is more important than these two. Oh Lord, give me courage and strength and wisdom, not courage, it's wisdom, to know the distinction between them.
Right, right.
So, this wisdom is required in the younger generation. I am available like with you and volunteer to guide all those people who want our guidance with our experience of, my experience of 42 years. My mail ID, my mobile is available through you to everyone to guide them what is good for them. Then they should decide themselves. My always feeling is, if you decide, and once you decide, do your best, you will get. Never regret. Even if your decision is wrong, never. I am telling you, one more thing I had was, I was very impatient for decision. I am telling you, impatient to decide. Very impatient to decide. Even now this quality or...
That's a strength.
I don't know.
I would
some
call
people,
it a strength.
Many call it strength. In my life, I always called it a strength. I was impatient to decide. I won't wait too much, you know. Now, what happened? Remembering and knowing fully well, some of my decisions can be wrong. And in financial world, it is more hazardous that you keep on taking decisions, some can go wrong.
Right.
Now that you take calculated decision by God's name and with no ill will
right.
and no malafide, some decisions will go wrong, of But I am telling you, impatient to... So these are restless people. These are impatient. They need to be counseled. They need to be taught. Then they should decide themselves.
Right.
What happens? Once they decide themselves, decision is their own.
Correct.
If you own anything, like work, if you own your work, then slowly you start enjoying. Initially, you may not. So I tell you, anybody doing whatsoever subject or course should start enjoying slowly, 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 by and by. Even that you don't like, you may start liking it. It may take 1 month, it may take 1 year, it may take 6 months. And if you really hate and don't want to develop liking, then better change it. And then whatever you change, then have the same love and passion for that also.
So that's a great commitment by Dubey sir. You know, he's available to guide and counsel anyone out there. If you have any queries, any questions, please share them in the comments under this video. And Mr. Dubey and I will make sure that you get all your answers.
100%. I believe in 100% connect with the people. When I was CMD Canara Bank, my mobile was known to 60,000 employees. Anybody could send message to me and he would get a reply. Maybe a blunt no also, but a reply. Somebody will attend in down the line, or I will give you what is possible.
So guys, you have a great mentor available right here. Whenever you have a career dilemma, whenever you have a confusion and you're not able to get the right Jamvant to guide you, you know, we have Mr. Dubey available. So stay tuned, keep watching these videos. Any last word of advice that Dubey sir would like to give to the students?
Yes. Never lose hope. Hope, one is dreaming, working hard. And never lose hope. Kabhi hatyar mat hatna. Kabhi himmat nahi harna. Never, never lose hope. Whatever bad happens in your life, there is a ray of hope for some other thing good to happen. Believe that way in your capability, God's capability. If something has gone wrong, something good is going to happen. If good times didn't continue for long, bad times would also not continue for long. They say, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? So keep hoping, keep working hard, be optimist. Whatever you want, sooner or later, it will happen. Surely it will happen. My best wishes to all of you.
So, kabhi hathiyar mat dalna. With those words of wisdom, we sign off from this session today. If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube page. It's youtube.com/tkwsibf. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. This is Amit Goyal signing off.